It's called The Tale of Xylo and the Magical Xylophone from the work Orchid Prolia by Robert Smith III. There once lived a red kitten who went by the name of Xylo, and Xylo never knew the reason why his parents named him Xylo. Now, Xylo was quite musical. There was nothing about music Xylo did not know. Everywhere Xylo went, the music would follow. One day, Xylo went traveling, and the music followed too. Xylo had no idea where Xylo was going to, until he heard a new music that was special to his ears, and he began to follow the music as if it was music to his ears, and he came upon a pile of rocks full of stones shaped like music notes, and he began digging at the pile full of stones shaped like music notes, and what he found truly was music to his ears. It was a magical red-colored xylophone, one that had never been discovered in ages, even years. And when Xylo and the xylophone connected, it was beautiful to behold. The music was so sweet, it was more precious than the finest gold. And everyone wondered forevermore at the music between the two. And they named Xylo the king of music, as well as the magical xylophone too. And they tell the tale of Xylo and the magical xylophone, saying, long live Xylo and the magical xylophone. The story right there is called The Tale of Xylo and the Magical Xylophone from the work Orchid Prolia by Robert Smith III.